The focus of my research revolves around humans in extreme environments, and a lot of the work we do is focused on modeling of the brain and traumatic brain injury. So the digital brain, you can think about it as basically a copy of your brain that sits in the cloud. And we use a number of different imaging modalities here at Penn State, for example, magnetic resonance diffusion tensor imaging and CT imaging. We take those images and we go through a pipeline and eventually get a three-dimensional representation in the computer, a virtual model of your brain. So once we have the virtual model of the human head, we then store it in a cloud like ICS, and then we have sensor companies who are collecting biomechanical data with wearable sensors. And so we sort of listen through their APIs and wait for an impact or a certain type of insult to occur. And then we read from their API, we get the data, and we put that onto the computational model of the brain. And then we try to give information back in terms of how that external loading was translated inside the brain. So it's unique because it's really the only way you can see real time how an external load propagates and its influence to the tissue inside. We have established a technique that to track the insults over time. So as the tissue feels that external load and might become damaged or disrupted, we keep track of that over time. And at the end, we can keep track of cumulative damage or cumulative effects to the brain tissue. My hope for the future of this field is that, you know, this computational brain biomechanics, which includes this concept of the digital brain, becomes part of a larger ecosystem of computational medicine. And we are able to use these techniques to monitor the injuries that occur. This is powerful because not all, you know, youth sports have an athletic trainer or a highly trained medical staff. And so having the ability to almost be a digital eyes on the field to quote unquote see the injury through sensors and then simulate that, hopefully will give medical physicians and personnel a lot more insight into how to treat it, what really happened, and how to monitor that over the career of an athlete.